shit.
Indeed. You've no idea what a pleasure it was for me to sign your execution order. Show Mr. Carter to his seat.
What's with the camera?
Posterity, Carter. I'm having you logged onto every official database for 10 light years in every direction. 100 billion witnesses to watch you die. I'm also having you patched into the log on my transport fighter, so I can watch it over and over every time I want a good laugh.
That's getting a little personal, wouldn't you say, Warden? I mean, what did I ever do to you?
Shut up. It's all over for you now.
Oh, it ain't over till the fat lady sings.
Well, I'll be damned. Not a fat lady in sight.
All right, you're in such a big hurry to watch me die. What are we waiting for?
Fortunately, we're waiting for the priest. He should have been here 10 minutes ago.
You gotta be kidding me.
Oh, regulations stipulate that the condemned man be granted last rites.
I'll pass.
Damn you, Carter. Have you no remorse at all?
For what?
For what? An entire deep space colony. Massacred. By you and your men. Men, women, and children. Watch it. Families, Carter. Families you were sent there to protect. And you say for what? God's sake, man. What happened to you?
I got bored.
I hope the devil has a special place for you. And for all your men. You're a disgrace to the uniform. An insult to humanity. An abomination in the eyes of God.
Oh, I don't know about that last one, Warden. You see, I've looked into the eyes of God, and you know what I saw there? Anarchy.
Finally. Now we can get on with this.
No, son. God offers you salvation. Even at your final hour. I give you absolution, my son.
Ready?
Just coming online with the program now, sir.
Guess you've never taken part in a jailbreak before.
No, don't shoot me!
I guess he never will.
Be out of this thing. Cut a little close, aren't you, Russell?
Don't complain. Springing a hardcore con from a maximum security prison takes time and money. And a little divine intervention.
Speaking of the real priest, where is he?
Meeting his maker. takeoff slot fueled and ready.
Get us some reinforcements!
How far can we get?
As far as we want. There's even sleep pods.
How many?
Six.
Cozy.
All right, gentlemen, let's get the hell out of here.
Man. Prison life is beginning to bore me.
Birthday. I'm 18 today. Big deal. I mean, it's not like anybody else is gonna notice.
Ronnie?
What?
Come and see what's happening.
Find another sunspot?
Just come on. You're always cooped up in here.
It's not like I can go outside and get fresh air.
Well, you know where we are.
Maybe they remembered this time.
Veronica.
Hi, Ronnie.
Come here. Look at this. What am I supposed to be seeing?
Something no human being has ever seen before. A dying star. Isn't it beautiful?
It looks the same as it did yesterday, and the day before that, the day before that.
What did you say?
I don't know. I'll be right back.
Oh, Ronnie. I'm sorry this mission has taken so long. We certainly never expected it to. What's that? It's probably nothing, but you stay here in your room until we call you, okay? Away from the nearest starbase. What the hell is a lone fighter doing way out here?
I don't know.
We're picking up a lot of interference from the star's magnetic field. It could have scrambled a signal.
We're gonna have to turn this thing around.
That means recalibrating all the instruments. It's gonna set us back days.
What else can we do? He's heading straight into the sun.
All right, let's do it. Veronica, buckle up. Be firing the thrusters for a few seconds. And stay put until you get the all clear. I hope we all die.
Carving thrusters on my mark. Mark.
It's cold in here.
Yeah.
Looks like it still has power, though.
Hey, have a look at this.
Oh my God, he's still alive.
Warning, life support failure.
Hey, what's happening?
Looks like the system just crashed. We must have tripped something opening the hatch.
My God, this guy's in cryogenic freeze. If he comes out cold turkey, he may not survive.
Okay, let's get him to the infirmary.
Can we handle that?
I think we'll manage. Should be coming out of it in the next few hours. No, I can't tell how long he's been under, but his vital signs are good. No trauma, no signs of contagion. The guy's clean.
Good. Well, if you've got a moment, there's something I'd like you to see on the fighter.
What?
It's kind of weird. Come.
What is it?
The whole fighter is weird. It's so outdated, it should be in a museum.
What happened to you?
spaceship.
Spaceship? Civilian spaceship?
Yeah. Well, actually, it's a deep space observatory. Can I have my arm back, please?
I'm thirsty. Is there any place on this tub where a guy could get a drink?
Yeah. Hang on.
Young to be a doctor, aren't you?
I'm not a doctor.
What are you then, if you don't mind my asking?
Well, I guess I'm the ship's cat. Why is that so funny? I mean, that's how they treat me.
Who?
My mom and the commander. Like, they're scientists, right? So I guess that's normal.
Scientists, where are they now?
I don't know. Oh, I think they went to go look at your fighter thing.
Watch this step.
And the rest of the crew?
It's just us.
Just you.
Now, have a look at this.
He's been out here 15 years.
That's right.
Are you okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm all right. It's just a little freezer burn, you know. What's your name?
Veronica. Everybody calls me Ronnie because it's easier.
Ronnie. I like that.
So I told you mine, you tell me yours.
Nash.
Well, I'm pleased to meet you, Nash.
Yeah.
What base is he from?
I can't tell. It's encrypted.
So how old are you, right?
I'm 18.
No. I would guess that you were at least 22.
Today is actually my birthday.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, happy birthday, Ronnie.
Thanks.
I hope you get everything you wish for.
Well, that's pretty standard military procedure to encrypt the flight recorder data. Our ship's computer should have no problem decoding it.
Ronnie, you want to hand me my clothes? A little bit of a draft, if you know what I mean.
Are you sure you're okay to get up?
I think so. Thanks.
So, are you a soldier?
What makes you say that?
Well, my mom used to be in the military once, and she had clothes like that.
What's she now?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Ronnie, it's a long story, and I won't bore you with it. You want to hand me my shirt?
I've got time.
Maybe later. Now, does this place have any long-range communications equipment?
Sure. Why?
Maybe when he comes to, he can tell us. But...
you know, I'm going to contact Terra Nova, let them know we have him. Maybe they can tell us something.
Good idea.
Okay.
This guy should not be out here.
Hey.
That looks about right. Let's see here. Ronnie, I'm gonna have to ask you to turn around. These military codes, they're classified.
Okay. So are you a spy?
Something like that. Okay. That ought to do it.
That was fast.
You just gotta know what to do. Now, Ronnie, like I said, this is classified, so let's just keep this between you and me, okay?
Okay.
If we start the recalibration, we could.
Mom, Cal, this is Nash.
It's nice to meet you.
Well, welcome aboard, Nash.
Yeah, I suppose I owe you people my thanks.
Well, it's lucky we came along when we did.
So we didn't expect to see you up so soon. How are you feeling?
Oh, everything seems to be working okay.
Really? Good, good. You had, quite the adventure. Do you know how long you've been in cold sleep?
I think you better sit down.
Years. I don't believe it.
Another 15 minutes and you were headed straight into the sun, young man.
Well, I guess it's kind of a miracle that you people were here for me and all.
So tell us what happened.
Truth is, I'm not really sure. I was just a mole, a grunt. Thank you, Ronnie.
Anytime.
I was a stoker on a deep space cruiser. We were on a recon mission. Well, one minute I was just minding my own business, doing my job. Next minute, everybody started screaming. Guys were yelling, running everywhere. The guys start shooting at me. I mean, me, why? I don't know. Bombs went off. That was fun. The alarm sounded, lights were flashing. Then, just to make things really interesting, some asshole decided to vape the goddamn ship. Ronnie said you used to be in the military, so I'm sure you can appreciate that kind of thing. God. 15 years.
Do you have any family?
Oh, not that I know of.
Well, that's probably a good thing considering the circumstances.
Yeah, I suppose so. Well, anyway, that's my story. What's yours? Ronnie here says you've been studying that red giant out there. That seems like a lot of work. You've been here a while?
Yeah, we've been here a while. We've been here a year and a half now.
A year and a half?
Mm-hmm.
pretty girl like you cooped up in a place like this for a year and a half, that's not healthy. I assume you at least begged her a birthday cake.
Oh, my God. Oh, Ronnie, I am so sorry.
Ronnie, I'm sorry. It was my fault. Your mother and I would have just been so busy. We clean forgot. We'll make it up to you, I promise.
I don't need you to make anything up to me, Commander. It's not like you're my father. Just because you two...
Ronnie.
Yeah.
You know, it's none of my business, but if it were me, I'd make it up to her right now.
Of course.
Hey, Chief, is that thing programmed to make alcohol? I mean, the real stuff with hangovers and everything, not that synthetic crap.
Yes, it is.
Can we?
Yes, sure. Of course, Ronnie, it's your birthday.
Thank you!
Oh, hey, take it easy. I've been frozen for 15 years. I'm still a little fragile.
I could use a drink myself.
Congratulations, Ronnie.
Go on, Ronnie. Make a wish.
All right. I'd like to make a toast.
To Cal, Billy, my new friends, especially to you, Veronica. But Ronnie, on your 18th birthday, may you have many more. Here's to being in the right place at the right time. What do you think there, birthday girl?
It tastes kind of... sour.
You'll get used to it.
Hey, before I forget, I found something on the ship. I think it belongs to you, and it looks like it has some sentimental value.
Yeah, it's,
Unfortunately, we're waiting for the priest.
Geez, I thought I'd lost this for sure.
I hope the devil has a special place for you. And for all your men.
It was given to me by...
You're a disgrace to the uniform.
By someone who got very close to me.
An insult to humanity. An abomination in the eyes of God.
For someone who's been asleep for 15 years, I'm suddenly awfully tired.
Oh, well, we have a room made up for you on deck 5. I'll take you up.
No, I'll do it.
Good night.
Good night. Get some rest.
Well, she is 18.
I didn't say a word.
So, what is your name anyway?
You know my name, Ronnie.
Not your other name.
Now, why would you want to know that?
Because I'm thinking about kissing you, and I want to be able to whisper sweet nothings in your ear.
Well, in that case, it's Lee.
Lee.
Mm-hmm. Lee Nash.
Lee Nash. I've never kissed a man before, Lee Nash.
Never.
Nope.
operation started. You know, I wanted to contact Terra Nova, but long range is down completely now.
The ship's falling apart. I'll fix it in the morning.
Any sign of Ronnie?
She's gonna have a hell of a head.
You know, maybe that's my fault.
What do you mean?
Well, I took this assignment right after David died because I just thought it would be good for Ronnie and I to be together, away from everything. But I certainly didn't count on...
What?
Us.
You think she blames me? I'm trying to take the place of her father or something.
Something like that, yes.
Well, then, you know, maybe this guy will be a good distraction for her.
Well, he certainly has an interesting story to tell.
That's for sure.
But I also think that we can cut him a little slack.
He's been on ice for 15 years.
And Veronica's certainly crazy about him.
She'll be fine.
Well, I don't know what to do. I mean, she already thinks that we're keeping her prisoner, so I... But... Maybe I should have a little chat with her.
Maybe that's a good idea. I'll have a word with Nash and set up some ground rules as far as Ronnie is concerned.
You're so good to us, Cal. And I appreciate that.
I love you, Billy. I'll do whatever it takes to make us work as a family.
Making me horny.
Veronica?
Oh, I hear
Veronica.
My mom. I hear my mom.
So there you go. It's got a bed and stuff, so. Everything okay?
Yeah.
Good. Can I have a word with you, Ronnie?
Sure. I'll see you later, Mr. Nash.
Good night.
Good night.
This baby.
about me getting drunk, isn't it?
No, my dear, that's another conversation entirely. I want to talk to you about our guest.
What about him?
I just want you to be really careful.
Careful?
Yes, because we don't know anything about him. And I don't want you getting so fond of him, you know, just in case.
In case what? You know, you're always trying to tell me what's right for me. Like, what right do you have getting all high and mighty? You're the one who's got the hots for our dear commander.
Veronica.
You're the one who's spitting on Dad's grave.
You wait a second.
No, wait. You wait a second. I've been living like a hermit for nearly 2 years here. And someone's come along who I can talk to, and he's interesting. And you're getting threatened by it? That's too bad.
You know, Veronica, I really shouldn't have to spell this out for you. This guy is a big question mark, and I don't want any adolescent fantasies getting the better of your judgment.
Adolescent! Adolescent!
Yes.
Get out! Just get out! I hate you!
You get some sleep.
It is the finding of this court-martial that you be stripped of your rank of officer and discharged from the service forthwith. Your lack of judgment has resulted in this disaster and the subsequent deaths of 12 of your fellow officers. Take her down.
I just dropped by to make sure you had everything you needed.
I got everything I need now.
Get used to it.
prison I'm made by someone who got very close to me.
You know, you're always trying to tell me what's right for me. Like, what right do you have getting all high and mighty? You're the one who's got the hots for our dear commander. You're the one spitting on Dad's grave.
Wait a second.
No, you wait a second. Thank you.
Oh, hey, take it easy. I've been frozen for 15 years. I'm still a little fragile. I'm not too big on rank. I guess you could say I've got a problem with authority. I'm not gonna have a problem with you, though, am I? Oh, I'll take that as a yes. Fart decided to be a hero, so I had to get a little medieval on him.
Now what?
Now it's time to introduce our special guests. Trails, Commander.
No! Don't! Please! Please, he doesn't have a chance. If the radiation doesn't kill him, the supernova will.
I'm afraid there's only enough room for one alpha male aboard this tub. You'd just be glad you're not going along for the ride.
I would rather we die out there with him than stay with you.
Unfortunately, I've got big plans for the two of you.
Look, I know you don't care. but let him live. And I'll cooperate. I can give you everything you want.
I got everything I want right here. You want to play with me? You want to play? Oh, I think you do. Come on, let's play! Help! And dies aboard this ship is determined by one person. That you screw with me again, and I will carve your little darling dog in Europe for supper. You got that?
Yeah.
Go. Now you take this last tube to the infirmary. Oh. And maybe I'll let you get some sleep.
Oh.
What a day.
Looks like you and me have a lot in common, huh?
What'd you do to my daughter?
What do you think I did? Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's a real thoroughbred. Suppose she takes after her mother, huh? Of course, the only way I'm gonna find that out for sure is to go for a ride myself. Hell, between the two of you, I could set up my own breeding farm right here on the station.
Oh, don't you touch her.
Save your strength, Mom. You're gonna need it.
Hey.
Wake up. Morning, sunshine.
Mom?
I'm right here, Veronica. It's okay.
Oh, it sure is. In fact, your mother and I were just talking, and I've decided to give you a second chance. What do you say? Didn't you enjoy our tender moment of love together?
You get your hands off her.
Ladies. Now, we are going to be living together for a very long time, so I suggest you find ways to make me happy. Because if I'm happy, you're happy. Now, Veronica, I thought we had something. I really did.
We do. I enjoyed what we did.
What we did together. There's so much more where that came from. You just let me show you. I mean, we just scratched the surface.
I'd like that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Come here. far you really go.
Thank you.
missile propellant access open. Warning. Emergency weapons access engaged.
Enough time to avoid the Nova.
How are you gonna know how to find him?
We'll find him. Hang on.
Cal gonna be okay? I know you love him. I don't want him to die.
I know that, sweetheart. I do. 63 minutes till critical mass.
That's not much time. I really messed up.
Oh, Veronica. Oh, don't ever think that. This was all my fault. This whole thing was my fault. And I'm so sorry he hurt you.
Mom, I'm gonna be okay, really. I'm not a child anymore. I've grown up.
Yes, my darling, you have. Okay. This plot will take us back to our original orbit. Now, there's something I need you to do for me. There may be a variance in propulsion that drives us off course. And you're gonna need to correct it.
You want me to drive this thing?
You can do it. You just keep the cursor at the bottom of that V. When this light goes on, you press that key.
Okay, what does it do?
Kicks the computer in the pants, and don't forget to hold on.
Where are you going?
I'm going sublevel. Veronica. Secure the door behind me.
Notice, but we're gonna have to dispense with the pleasantries. We got a situation here.
Just where exactly is here?
It's a deep space observatory.
And what kind of situation?
Well, the ship is under my control, but it's developed a bit of a problem. See, I got a couple of women running around playing hard to get. I need you guys to take care of it.
Cutter's got some women problems. Cutter's a man!
He
We listened to you before, and look where it got us.
Hey, give it a rest. You're alive, aren't you?
Yeah, by the grace of God. I say we vote on who gives the orders around here. No offense, Carter, but you're a damn psychopath.
None taken. Anybody else want to vote?
No, boss. We're with you.
Yeah, we're with you, man. Yeah, all the way.
Good.
All right. Gentlemen, help yourselves. Now everybody make sure you got one of these. Daddy wants to keep tabs on you at all times. We're gonna start at the bottom, work our way up.
What do we do if you find him?
You can do whatever you want. Just make sure you call the rest of us before you kill him. Move out.
Check in there.
Got it.
Did you get her?
I said hands up.
You wouldn't want to shoot him out of the cloth, no. Would you?
I wouldn't want to. But I will.
All right, everyone listen up. Stay down there. She's probably still close.
Thank you.
She's headed your way. You said we lost her.
No, we didn't.
She's dead, and you can wipe that shit-eating grin off your face and get your ass over to the coolant room. If Lars here screws up, that's where she's gonna come out.
Okay, boss.
Me.
I can see that. Ronnie, open the door.
No. No way.
I'm not gonna hurt you, Ronnie. I love you.
I said no. Now go away.
Down the gun and come out of there.
You first, shithead.
Shithead, I like that. Of course, I would have preferred Pookie or Buttercup. Your weapon. Come on, Ma. You don't want to make a decision you're going to regret later.
Bad decisions are all in my past.
This is your only course of action left, Billy.
Yeah. You're forgetting something, Nash. I've turned the ship around. You don't surrender soon, it's over for all of us.
You know what I always say? It ain't over till the fat lady sings.
How'd you like that song? Our friend Nash was 15 years behind the times. Okay, we intercept Cal in 8 minutes.
How long before the star goes nova?
About 10.
Mom? That's not much time.
Yeah, let's get him docked.
That's what I get for being a gentleman. Time to die.
This is between you and me. You let her go.
Oh, Mom. You're breaking my heart.
Run.
calls her a bitch, huh? You hang in there, Ma. I'll be right back. Join me in a bedroom, Ronnie. Brings back memories, doesn't it? What's this?
July 1st, a miracle has happened. He was totally naked when I first saw him lying there, unconscious in the infirmary, and I've never seen a naked man before. Well, except in vids. He gave me the tingles. I wanted to make love to him right there.
Oh, that's sweet. It really is, Ronnie. Unfortunately, the expiry date on my interest for you is long past. Now, this can be quick or this can be slow. It's your choice. Big girl, Veronica. But I see you hiding there under your bed like some kind of scared child, frightened of monsters, and I really have to wonder.
I'm not a child.
That was a mistake.
You're the mistake.
Whole world of pain, you little
Carter!
Cal! Thank God you made it!
That's right. I'm gonna teach you a lesson. That's for Ronnie. That's for Billy. And this is for me.
Take it easy there, Chief, because you don't want to kill the groom before the wedding.
Well, guess what? The wedding's off.
Cal.
Look, girl. How are you?
I'm okay.
Where's your mother?
She was shot.
She was what?
She's shot. Mom?
Cal.
Mom?
We've got to go.
Yeah. Well, what about him?
That's a good idea. That's Chief, why don't you?
Leave.
Just give me a hand here. No hard feelings. No, wait. Don't leave me here. You're never gonna make it!
July 2nd. Kyle says Mom will be okay and a doctor will meet us tomorrow. The red giant is dead, and so is the girl I was just yesterday. A pulsar now beats like a newborn heart where the star once burned. As my stepfather says, out of death, new life always springs. I'm not sure whether it'll be better or worse than the old, but it'll be different. And there's no going back.
Dad?
Yeah?
Thanks.
That's all right, Ronnie.